to the Catholic Church and then going to a Protestant church and,
right.
you know, and then doing Buddhist chants. And I'm going, well, what is this all about? And my grandmother would just say, well, it's all spirit.
Yeah.
But there's another side of spirit with the Japanese really also connect with, and that is the spirit of people. And sometimes these spirits do beneficial things, and sometimes they do not beneficial things. And then you get into this thing about malevolent ghosts and so on, and people coming back. And there's a whole tradition in Hawaii, anyway, about in the Japanese community there, about ghosts and spirits and so on. And it's just, it's fascinating, this word spiritual and what it brings
up
for people.
Well, that's because, right, everything is spirit.
Right.
And Shinto regards nature. You know, every Shinto shrine is in a forest.
Right.
If it's not a whole forest, at least it's a tree.
Right.
You know, they'll put up brand new, sparkly, shiny office buildings, but they won't take down the Shinto shrine, and they'll leave one tree, you know, in this little tiny, not even alleyway, just like maybe, you know, this little 4x4 area. They
right.
won't take it down because it's the spirit of the land and God together.
Right.
I studied some Shinto, and every day when I'm in Japan, I go to Meiji Shrine because my apartment is near there.
Uh-huh.
And do the ceremony called Oharai, and that means it's a purification and blessing. Actually, I do that in part of my practice. You know, we learn it in Reiki level 2, using the symbols to clear the energy in the room,
uh-huh.
or actually to balance the energy to neutral.
Uh-huh.
Which is a clearing, basically.
Right.
And I've used the Shinto as well. So in my ceremony to clear the energies of a room or even someone's car, when they buy a used car or a new car, to make it neutral for them and then to bless it and purify it, I use Shinto and Buddhism, Buddhist chants and things like that, whatever required at the time. But to get back to spirit and divine energy, everything is spirit, everything is divine energy. It's just our education that has separated us from the real spirit of everything. We were taught spiritual feeling is religion, but actually religion is spiritual feeling. I'm sorry to some people, but religion is a controlling thing of spirit.
Right.
And so it got a little perverse. But I also understand that as if the religion itself wasn't strict and a bit fearful, then people would not get it. They would not develop a kind of faith. And actually what they are trying to develop the faith is faith in the higher power, that they can trust the higher power and like that. You did mention about, okay, so there's spirit in everything, in the trees, in the mountains, in the flowers, in the water, in everything, in the rocks. And there's also the spirit of the people, which is beneficial or not.
Right.
But spirit of people is, I mean, it's spirit. We come from spirit, and we go back to spirit. Okay,
uh-huh.
So whatever we are on this earth, just like there are really good people doing really good things, there are also people who do other kinds of things that, as you said, that are not so beneficial. But they are like that in spirit too. That's why when I do Oharai in a house, the purification and blessing, sometimes there is a ghost in there. Okay, I'm not particularly looking for ghosts, but as I mentioned to you, I'm highly sensitive, and I can tell when there's something there in that room. And most of the time, it's the ghost of a person who is stuck between two worlds. They have died, but they don't really know it.
Right.
Because they say on the other side that we also behave somewhat like we do in our life, just we don't have the physical form, so we cannot really expiate our karma. It's only in the in this lifetime when we are in a physical form that we can expiate karma. So sometimes there's a person who, had it been an accident or a sudden death or something, they don't really know they're dead. So they're kind of stuck in their house or wherever.
Right.
And so sometimes they're not bad. They just need help to go, you know, completely off into the light. And also, there are some that are very naughty ghosts and the poltergeists and doing naughty things, just like people do in, you know, in our world now. But they're you know, if certain people synchronize with a very, I'm going to say very low and base energies, then they will synchronize with these kind of fearful beings, just as they do, you know, in life. You know,
right.
Certain kind of people, you know, just gather together.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
beautiful.
Just like that. So I don't, as long as you don't have fear about these things, fear will bring you into a lower vibration. But Reiki brings us into a very, very high vibration. Remember, the lots of people, after they're attuned, they always see the purple, most spiritually high color, right? And the green, which is the color of the heart, which is the love energy.
Uh-huh.
So Reiki people are always saying, oh, I see purple, I see green. It's like, yeah, because that's the highest spiritual energy, and it's of the heart.
Uh-huh. So okay. For you, these colors that people see, like during initiation or during Reiki treatments, or maybe just waking up in the morning and having this like after sleep kind of revelation, that this, they're seeing the energy that's around them.
Yes, they're seeing what they synchronize
what
with.
They synchronize. Oh, that's interesting, because quite often what people say is, well, that's, they personalize it, and you know, I don't know, they personalize it in a way that feels like it's for that person only. But I really get your explanation of it, which I really like, actually. So I remember you asking me to go to your website and look at the Reiki Aura video, which, of course, I didn't do, not because I didn't want to, but I just have had no time since we saw each other. So I'm sure that the listeners would love to hear about this, and I would too. And then I can listen to, I can look at it with more educated. So what is the Reiki Aura video? And, you know, just tell me about it.
Okay. Well, as we know, there's been around for a while this Kirlian camera.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And so that will take a picture of us, but it will show our aura colors. Okay. So, but we always think that, well, our colors change, because as emotions change, our colors change. But as I learned from the man, who invented the video of this aura camera, that the more, he said, if I took more aura pictures of you, you would see a consistency of your main color, of where you're always vibrating. But of course, I didn't need to do that, because I know where I am. You know, I know where I'm always vibrating. And if I get angry, yeah, I'm red. Or, you know, and if I'm totally spiritual, I'm white.
Uh-huh.
Because through the color comes to us in this particular lifetime, the way we see color is, you know, like if the Reiki white light comes down, when it touches on our crown chakra, the vibration at the crown is so high that it shows purple, the most high psychic color, and the other colors are just not visible, because it vibrates only at the frequency of purple.
Uh-huh.
And as the Reiki ray comes down through the crown and goes to the area of the third eye, that vibration is different than the crown. So it's vibrating at indigo blue violet.
Uh-huh.
Okay, because that's the frequency of the vibration, so it shows that color. And on down, the throat chakra will vibrate at sky blue.